Hello.
Hola. I'm now Spanish. I just realized we're both wearing white t-shirts.
Lovely.
I know. Okay. So I wrote my stuff down for my topic because I have ADD and I have a very hard time concentrating. So, yeah. So, my topic is going to be the, what is it called?
Topic 3, it's the FTM MTF topic.
Obviously, I'm FTM. So, yeah, the first thing says, how do you qualify legally for SRN and HRT? So, pretty much, I'm already on hormones, and I qualified for T because I got a note from my therapist. And that kind of was really annoying because basically we traveled to Westwood, which is near our area, but it's like, what, like an hour on the bus?
Yeah, it's in UCLA and we live in like near North Hollywood area, so it's kind of pretty far.
Yeah, I mean, it's like,
what? It's like an hour on the bus.
Yeah, an hour on the bus. I mean, it's not that far, like by car, but I don't know. We traveled there, and I went there for, like, two sessions, and then it was really expensive, and I was paying for it myself, and so I was like, no, I can't do this anymore. So I stopped going, and then when I wanted to get tea, this whole shenanigans happened, and then I ended up going to this, like, top doctor. Yeah, I'm messing with things. See, I have ADD. See? Okay, no, I will drink water. Okay, anyway. So, I stopped going there, and then, so the other doctor, Dr. Olson, who I'm now going to, required a letter to start T, and I was like, well, I've seen this lady, like, twice, and I think she wants to give me her letter, blah, 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 and then we called her, and she didn't answer. She didn't answer for, what was it, like a month?
It was like a month.
And yeah. Apparently that whole month she was on vacation. And I thought she was just like ignoring our calls. I didn't know what was happening. And that was really annoying. So within that time, I decided I should probably start going to another therapist to try and get her to know me to get the letter because I didn't think the other one was going to follow through. And it ended up that she was on the vacation. And so as soon as she came back, she called my doctor, and she said it was all cool and everything, and she wrote up a letter and everything like that. Okay, that took 3 minutes. Okay. All
right. So the next question was...
So that was annoying.
Do you have to attend gender therapy for a certain amount of time?
I did not have to attend for a certain amount of time. I only did two sessions, like I said. But usually, I mean, depending on your doctor and where you get your tea and your therapist and everything, like, depending on how he or she feels or whatever, it kind of varies, but usually it takes longer, usually, but, yeah.
All right, the next question is, do you have to be living as your gender for a certain amount of time?
Usually it's, like, a year, I think, right?
I think something like that, a year. Most places.
According to some places.
I think you just got really lucky with the whole
situation. Yeah, I did. I didn't have to wait. She didn't really care about that. Like, my first session with her, she was just kind of like, she talked to me for like an hour and then did my blood work and everything, but pretty much she was like, well, yeah, I know you know what you want and everything, and I know this is right and all this stuff, but, and you're also like, not underage, so that's definitely a plus. So pretty much I want to get you started as soon as possible. So as soon as I made that appointment with her and had that appointment and everything, it was all good. So I just got really lucky, I guess.
All right, the next one is, how many letters did you need from gender therapists, if any?
I needed one for my testosterone. But when I do have top surgery, I think I'm going to need two, so I might, like, talk to that therapist again, I guess, when I'm able to afford top surgery. And then probably my doctor, Dr. Olson, that gives me my tea, I'm sure she'll be able to write me a letter. So, too.
I think it depends on, like, how long you've been on tea. Like, at a certain point when you're on tea, they see if you're, like, happy or something.
Okay.
I don't know.
There you go.
If you are or were underage, would your parents have to sign off one or both?
I am not underage, but if I was, my mom would sign off.
Okay. Do you have to travel to a different region to get hormones, therapy, or surgery?
For hormones, since I live in LA, we live in LA, it's very easy to, find a place and everything, and there's a lot of places. But, so yeah, we don't really have to travel. We go to West Hollywood, really close. But, for top surgery, I'm planning on hopefully going to, like, Dr. Garamoni. I know that's, like, very stereotypical, but he does a really good job. So, yeah, I'll see about that, but that would be awesome. Yeah, and in December, I might start a thing online where you can, like, donate $1 or so. I'm just really poor, and I need top surgery really bad. So that might happen in, like, December. I'm going to set up a PayPal account. I can't right now because things with my bank and everything, but, yeah. I don't know why.
You mean a chip-in account, right?
Yeah.
You confused me for a second. I was just like, so that you can donate something. I was just like...
Oh, no. Sorry.
So a chip-in account as in people donate to you to help you save money for top surgery.
Like $1. Like, you know? Like
a quarter if you
whatever
want.
Whatever the hell you want.
It doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. Be nice, be stingy, whatever.
So when that comes around...
Hook it up.
Yeah.
Hook it up, sister.
I'll let you know.
All right. Is that
that's it for yours? Is it?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, it is, I think.
All right.
Okay.
My turn.
I'm done. I'm done rambling.
Okay, first of all, let me start off by saying that I was going to do a queer artists one, but,
because she's amazing and at the guitar and singing.
Shut up. But, one of the things was do something related to, like, why does my music relate to queerness, I guess. My music doesn't really relate to queerness at all. It's kind of just, like, I write a song and I play it, and it doesn't really have anything to do with being gay. So I just, you know, maybe eventually I'll do a song for this collab, but as of right now, I can't really think of anything that would be queer-related, so... Thank you. Rude. All right, so my topic instead is going to be coming out. The first question was, how did region affect your coming out process? My region kind of didn't really affect it at all. I lived in San Diego up until I moved up to LA to be with Landon, so my whole life. But, I mean, San Diego's pretty... I don't know, it's a pretty... understanding place. It's not really, you know, like, in the Bible Belt or anything like that, so I mean, I was pretty accepted. It took me, because when I came out in middle school, and middle school is, like, really hard to come out in general. It doesn't matter where you are, like, middle school, just people are judgmental and whatever, but as soon as I got to high school, like, it was a lot better, you know. There's a lot more, queer people at high school. And it was just a lot easier for me, so my region didn't really matter for coming out. The next question is, do you feel it would be easier to come out if you lived in a different region? No. As I said before, now that I live in Los Angeles, basically half the town is gay, so it's really easy to be gay in this area. But yeah.
It's easy to be gay.
It's easy to be gay here. as you go through life, you still have to come out to the people you meet. How does region affect this process? I've come out to my close family, like, a couple of my cousins and aunts and, like, my close aunts and uncles know that I'm gay, and all of my friends know that I am, and all of that, but,
I think some of your other family knows, they just don't say anything.
I was getting to that. But
sorry, I'll
show. But a lot of my distant family, including like my grandpa and stuff like that, like the older generation, don't really know. And if they do know, they choose not to say anything because of the fact that they just. It's not that they don't accept it, they just don't really understand it, you know? I mean, I've brought Landon to a couple of family events, and they say, oh, your friend, and blah, 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 but they probably, you know, assume that, But now
it's
that...
Weird.
It's gonna be weird, though, because Landon's gonna be transitioning, and as soon as his voice drops and everything, and he gets more masculine and whatever, it's gonna be different, because I guess I'll be straight. Or something? I don't know.
Or
bi, or I don't know. What the hell? Pansexual. Let's just go there.
Kind of.
Kind of. I am. Shut up. I only love you. Just chill. It's okay. do you live in a conservative town, city, state, or country?
No. Never will.
Well,
no,
you would think that we aren't. Because it's California, and we've got the gay capital, which
We're
is
not.
San Francisco. But the whole Prop 8 thing, it's kind of made me think differently about that. We're not conservative at all. I don't think we are in the least bit, at least compared to Texas, definitely not.
Our state isn't, like...
Our state is a very liberal state, but the thing is that we've got... There's a lot of confused people in this state that don't know what they want, and they hear the wrong things, and they see commercials, and they get the wrong idea about a lot of stuff.
And the way they word it and everything, and how they said no on Prop 8, you kind of want to vote yes, like, oh yes, we want gay marriage.
Yeah, it was a very... It was really confusing to a lot of people, and that's why it was like a 52-48 percentile. And that's why people, you know... This whole debate is still going on, and people aren't letting go because of the fact that a lot of people were misjudged in the whole situation, but
so don't
generally...
support Twilight, because that is the problem, and I'm sorry any
That's
of
totally
you Twilight
not even
fans.
In the topic.
No, but about Prop 8, okay? Okay, we're going on a whole different little... Okay.
Yeah, but we're on, like, 12 minutes right now, and we can't...
Yeah, sorry. Shut up.
All right, but the end of that topic, no, we don't live in a conservative area, but I'm very confused about the whole Prop 8 thing. Anyways, are you judged by the people around you because of your gender identity or sexual preference, or are they okay with it? Do you think region affects this? No, I don't think people judge me on that. I think it's just part of who I am, you know, like... You know, just my whole identity and everything, it kind of revolves around the fact that, you know, I have my sexual preference and, you know, how I look, everything just, you know, kind of revolves around it. I mean, that doesn't, like, that's not the only thing that defines me, obviously, but, you know, it's just, it's kind of a part of me, and if people don't accept it, then I don't really prefer to talk to them, and if they do judge me, then I don't really pay attention to it. It's just, I've never really paid attention to people, you know, being snarky towards me since I was in, like, early high school age, so it doesn't, I don't really get judged at all. Okay, so I can talk about anything else in the video.
I think we've made this video really long, so I think this should be the end of it.
All right. Well, came out when I was 13, 19 now, so I've been out for 6 years. I'm really happy with who I am, really happy with my relationship.
Better be.
I am, I promise. This is a really long video, really sorry. So yeah, thank you guys. We'll be back next week, I believe.
Oh.
I think next week. If not next week, the week after. So,
I just cut myself.
There's a good
hurt.
End of the video. Landon
Bye.
Got a water bottle cut. Bye.